Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
We are going to present about the CIMB Islamic Liquidity Ratio performance.
Well, liquidity is basically how easy an asset can be turned into cash. Financing illiquid assets with liquid assets is among the process of liquidity creation. So the banks are required by Bank Negara Malaysia to withhold a certain amount of reserve called the bank's reserve requirement.
I will explain about the background of CIMB Islamic Bank. CIMB is the abbreviation for Commerce International Merchant Bankers. So CIMB Group Holding Berhad was founded in January 2006. But in 2009, CIMB and CIMB Islamic Bank moved to a new headquarters. So CIMB Islamic Bank is the global Islamic banking and finance services franchise of CIMB Group. They offer innovative and comprehensive Sharia compliance financial solution in investment banking, consumer banking, asset management, private banking, and wealth management. So, it has 350 branches of CIMB Bank in Malaysia. CIMB Islamic is now the third largest Islamic bank in Southeast Asia in terms of total asset and deposit.
There are two methods to monitor liquidity. Among those two are cash flow ratios and traditional ratios. A cash flow ratio is taken from the statement of cash flows which were prepared according to the cash basis. A traditional ratio is taken from the balance sheet and income statement which were prepared according to the accrual basis. Basically, cash flow ratios are more effective to monitor liquidity because cash flow ratios give more information about the bank's ability to meet its commitment.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Masnia binti Abdul Karim. I will present about cash deposit ratio. So, cash deposit ratio is a ratio of how much a bank lend out their deposit it has mobilized. So, it indicates how much of a bank core fund are being used for lending. Cash in a bank vault is the most liquid asset for a bank. Therefore, a highest DR indicates that a bank is relatively more liquid than a bank which has a lower CDR. So, the formula for cash deposit ratio is cash divide by deposit. Okay, for CIMB Islamic Bank CDR, from the graph we can see that the highest cash deposit ratio is on the year of 2016, because the bank has a because this year CIMB Islamic Bank has cash of 8 million and their deposit only 90,388 ringgit. So during 2016, the bank is more liquid compared to another year. So this is because banks has created more cash asset from its deposit compared to other year. And from this graph also we can see that the lowest cash deposit ratio is in year 2014 with only 23.45%. Low cash deposit ratio means the money in the bank are not enough, as some percent of bank should have available so that the customer can be paid. Okay, that's
it. My name is Aida Shafika, 240990, and I will be explaining about CIMB Islamic's bank performance on the aspect of liquidity using the current asset ratio. So basically this ratio shows the bank's asset structure. This ratio shows composition of firm's asset. The higher the value of this ratio indicates that the firm has more liquid assets than long-term assets. So the formula is as above, current asset divided by the total assets. So these are the graphs, I mean the bar charts of CIMB Islamic's current asset ratio performance. So we can see that the highest current ratio was in the year 2017. Among the five years of comparison, there hasn't been a big difference between the years. However, the range has been 0.9 to indicate that a firm has a good liquidity ratio, shows that it has to be more than one. However, since the current asset ratios all are in the range of 0.9, it doesn't mean that CIMB Bank is poorly. It just means that because there hasn't been a, I mean, between the years there has been an increase. So it means that it's doing good within its competitive advantage over other companies. Thank you.
Assalamualaikum and a very good afternoon to Doctor. Today, my name is Nur Amiratika, metric number 240954. Today, I would like to present about loan deposit ratio of CIMB Islamic. Okay, loan deposit ratio is a ratio between the bank's total loans and total deposits. The ratio is generally expressed in percentage term. So, the loan to deposit ratio is used to calculate bank's ability to cover withdrawals made by their customers. Banks that accept deposits must have a certain measure of liquidity to maintain its normal daily operation. So, the formula for loan deposit ratio is loans divided by deposit. So, as you can see, based on the graph, CIMB Islamic loan to deposit ratio the lowest ratio is on 2013, which is 77.9%, providing room for CIMB Islamic to engage in active asset liability management to defend its margin. The highest loan deposit ratio is on 2015, which showed that CIMB Islamic has 89.2%, which takes more financial stress by making excessive loan compared to other years. So most banks, including CIMB Islamic, affected by weak deposit growth, which make the industry's loan deposit ratio had risen in the past 5 years. As you can see, in 2015, CIMB Islamic have affected by the weak deposit growth. So that's why their percentage is highest. But then in 2016 and 2017, the percentage declined to 87.2% on 2016 and 85.8% on 2017. Okay, it is actually okay for CIMB Islamic to have this kind of percentage on the past 5 years, because their percentage is not over 90%. So they still have enough deposit, they still have enough liquidity to maintain their operation. Okay, that's all for me.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Nur Asma binti Ahmad Said. My metric number is 240967. Then I will proceed to the current ratio of CIMB Islamic Bank. So basically, current ratio is the most basic liquidity test. It shows the bank ability. If current ratio is greater or equal to 1, this indicate that the current ratio should be able to meet near terms obligation or its current liabilities, and a current ratio less than 1 may mean that the firm has liquidity issues. So the formula for the current ratio that has been used is current asset divided by current liabilities. What is current asset? Current asset is a cash and other assets that are expected to be converted to cash within 1 year. While the current liabilities is amount due to be paid to the creditor within 12 months. So then I will proceed to the CIMB Islamic current ratio performance based on the graph. The most higher current ratio is on the year 2016 with 1.0755%. While the lowest is on the year 2013 with 1.035%. So this indicate that on the year 2016, CIMB Islamic Bank has the most liquid of their, in terms of their current ratio. So it means that the banks are more efficient in operating cycle or its ability to turn its product into cash. Basically, current ratio has been used to make a rough estimation of a bank financial health. A high current ratio generally considered as a good sign for a bank. CIMB Islamic is better in maintaining in current ratio as it did not fall below than 1%. As you can see, from 2013 until 2017, CIMB Islamic Bank current ratio has a ratio that has a ratio higher than 1%. It means that CIMB is still maintaining its good ability in its ratio. That's all. Thank you. Continue to the last part, which is conclusion. As a conclusion, liquidity ratio as a part of accounting ratio is important tools in financial analysis. So basically, bank performance is very important in order to identify the ability of the bank to pay its debt, to evaluate the bank performance, as well as to assess the bank value. As you can see, based on the four ratios that we have been evaluate, CIMB Islamic Bank has a good sign in its liquidity ratio in terms of their cash deposit ratio, loan deposit ratio, current asset ratio, and its current ratio. But there is less favorable on current asset ratio due to current asset ratio is less than 1. CIMB Islamic has a favorable health in its financial position, as it is not facing any problem that might arise, such as insolvency and mismanagement by manager. CIMB has a positive signs of ability to meet their short-term obligation. And lastly, CIMB Islamic Bank has a good in maintaining its financial stability for the bank, as it is help for the bank to have more current asset over its current liability. That's all.